Hi guys, and welcome to DriveSpark. I'm Promit Ghosh, and today we are reviewing a maxi scooter from Suzuki. It's called the Burgman Street, and I'll give you a quick walk around of what this scooter actually looks like and what all features it has. So let's get started. So yeah, as you can see guys, this is the all new Burgman Street. I'll just give you a quick walk around of this scooter so you can actually have a look at how the scooter actually looks like. As you can see, it's a pretty bulky and handsome looking scooter out here compared to the rest in the market at the current stage. So yeah, so let's get started and let's start off with the front. So you can see it's got a pretty bulky looking front, these aprons both the sides, and talking about these headlights, pretty fancy looking headlights. Let me just switch them on for you. It's an all LED headlight, plus you get DRLs over here and over here, and these two are the high beams. So you can see all the three lights are illuminated and gives it's a pretty bright headlight, and throw is pretty amazing. As you can see, now the indicators are usually towards the side of the scooter or towards upwards on the handlebars, but over here you get the indicators integrated in these side panels. As you can see, it looks really classy with the headlight, plus you get the Suzuki logo right on top over here. And if you come right above, you get this standard body mount windscreen that looks pretty awesome, pretty good. On the side also, if you have a look, it gives a good appeal to the scooter. Plus here guys, you get these scooters come fitted with alloy wheels both front and back, and I'm sorry, it's a rainy season, so I mean it's a bit dirty, the alloys. I don't know how much you clean the scooter, it gets dirty as soon as possible. So yeah, you can see you get alloy wheels, and it gets tubeless tires, plus it gets a disc at the front over here. If you see, yeah, it gets a disc brake, Nissan disc calipers. They provide a pretty good bite. Let's stop the scooter really fast, I must say. And plus over here, you get the combi, you get the combi brake system. Over here, you get an all LED instrument cluster. You can see, this is the first scooter that has featured an all LED instrument cluster. It's pretty neat, it's pretty bright. You can see it's a pretty sunny, not exactly a sunny day, but it's a pretty bright day. But still, I mean, you can read it from a far distance also. There's no issue. It has a white backlight. You get, this is the speedometer. You get two trip meters. This trip A, trip B. And then you get, this is the odometer. You get the time and you get the fuel gauge. Plus high beam, light, indicators and all of that. Over here, so for the indicators, high beam, low beam, on, plus this is the starter, and you get no, again, you get no headlight on off button. These are automatic headlight, so as soon as you hit the ignition button, the headlights just go on. This scooter has a really lot of storage space. As you can see, I have got a 1 liter bottle over here, plus you can see this compartment over here. It's claimed to be around 2 liters. But the 1 liter bottle can fit really perfectly. Over here, you get a lock for the ignition. You press this immediately. It's a push shut. So you push this, and then with the key over here, you just insert it over here and open it. An extra safety feature, I feel it's really good. Over here, you get a hook so that you can hook on to extra luggage or your grocery stuff or whatever. Standard hook over here is the same. This goes in like this if you want it. Opens up like this. Plus, yeah, guys, an interesting fact about this is another glove box, as you can see. A lot of storage. You can store your mobile, some of your documents. And this has got a charger, as you can see here. It's got a charging socket over here. So that's really handy. As you can see, it's a 12 watt charging socket. But you need to buy the charging socket. It's an aftermarket thing. Buy it, plug it, and charge on the go. But this also comes with this rubber padding, so it makes it really waterproof. There's no water. I've been putting my phone inside and riding in this rain. Luckily, my phone and some of my papers and my wallet has not yet got drenched. So, but the only thing is that if they would have provided it with a lock, would have been much better. Lot of foot space. Plus, additionally, they have given this, the additional footrest. So, when you're going on the highway, just place your foot on the front. It becomes a really comfortable position for you to sit and ride. Plus, you get the Burgman Street logo over here, as you can see. So, this is the Burgman Street logo. So the rare guys, you get a all LED tail light. You see, it's an all LED tail light over here. Let me just light it up for you once. Yep, you can see, looks really smart. But indicators are still, bulbs are there. I wish that they would have given an all LED indicator also. Would have complemented the scooter a lot. Now coming to the seats, as you can see. Seat is pretty wide, pretty long, pretty big, and it's a pillion friendly seat. As you can see, it's got these red stitchings over here. It gives it a premium touch. See, it's really comfortable and it's pretty soft. As you can see, cushioning is nice. So yeah, so from here only you get to open the boot. So you just press it once like this, the storage box opens, and you get a 21.5 liter storage capacity. That's the biggest in its class. You can see, only drawback I felt, not a drawback exactly, the only thing that I felt that they should have added is an LED light to the boot, so that at night if you're keeping something or you're searching for some papers, it would have been easy. Here you get the petrol hose. With this you get a medical kit, tool kit. So speaking about the engine guys, it's the same 125cc engine that powers the Suzuki Axis 125. And it's got a really amazing mid-range. It's got really amazing pickup too, I must say, for a scooter. It's 8.6 bhp and 10.2 nm of torque. Mileage, company claims to give around 53, but in the real life, I guess what I have tested by riding this till now is that you can get a mileage of around, say, 40 to 45. Yeah, 40 to 45, depending on what speeds you ride. I mean, if you're belting the scooter too hard, obviously you will get less mileage. Otherwise, if you're riding really calm, like a 60, between a 50 to 60, you'll get really amazing mileage, guys. So, yeah, just have a look at the maxi scooter once again. It's a really cool looking scooter. Catches a lot of attention, you can see, because of its styling. And it's really bulky from the front. Though it's bulky, it's a really fast scooter, I must say. Yeah, guys, that was the all-new Burgman Street from Suzuki. If you like this video, please subscribe, share, and don't forget to subscribe to all our social media channels. Till then, I'm Promit signing out. Thank you for watching.